Hello.
Yes, is this Mr. Burton?
This is Richard Burton. Who's calling, please?
My name is Harland Sanders, Mr. Burton, and I wondered if I might talk to you for a moment or two.
It's Burton. How may I help you, sir?
I'm an American entrepreneur, basically. And I heard that you're in Hollywood about to start a production on a film where you're going to play King Henry,
Henry the Eighth.
Henry the Eighth, exactly. And, I wanted to reach out to you specifically to talk to you about the image of Henry the Eighth. And I'm wondering if you were going to stick to the very familiar and historically accurate depiction of that famous monarch.
Well, of course we endeavor to do that whenever we can. It's a very important part of depicting anyone from history. We owe a certain debt to the audience to depict things as accurately as possible.
Well, good then. I imagine that you're going to honor the image that we have, at least in this country, of Henry VIII brandishing a large chicken leg, and sometimes punctuating his speech by waving that chicken leg around and things like that.
I believe you're mistaken there, Colonel.
Oh, no, I've seen it many times. It's in paintings and in other films, and I had a postcard of it one time. Somebody sent from, I believe it's from England.
Yes, what I mean is that I don't believe it's a chicken leg.
I don't?
No, it's too large. It's a leg of mutton.
Oh, it's not a chicken leg.
No, it's a different animal entirely. Now, if there's nothing else...
Oh, that's fine. I think you're right, actually, now that I think about it. I always just assumed it was a particularly large chicken leg. Maybe back in olden times, chickens, they grew them larger. But, of course, that doesn't...
No, it's not the case.
Yeah, it doesn't make any sense at all.
No.
Well, that being as it may, I'm sure that in your Henry the Eighth movie, you're going to have a lot of eating scenes. Isn't that right?
Yes, of course.
And if that's the case, then well, you see, I'm a chicken entrepreneur, basically. I've got a small company, I guess a startup, you'd call it.
Oh, really? Do you?
Yeah, and I just run it myself right now. But I was thinking there might be an opportunity for some cross-promotion if you, in your own particular film, held up one of my Kentucky Fried Chicken legs and brandished it around and, substituted that for maybe one of them mutton legs. Mutton, I don't think, is quite as salubrious. Anyway, it can give you a powerful gut ache.
Extra points for using the word salubrious, but it's not exactly my department, Colonel.
It's not, huh?
No, the property master usually takes care of these things.
Oh, I see. Oh, dear.
However, Colonel, you have caught me at an interesting time. I happen to be a little economically pressured at the moment. And, I'm trying to purchase a very expensive ring for my wife.
Oh, is that right?
Yes, and so I'm not above investigating some financial opportunities that might arise from, say, a sort of product placement.
Well, that's exactly what I was talking about. I'd be willing to recompense you, Mr. Burton, for holding up one of my legs of chicken in your show.
Would I need to consume any of it?
Well, not necessarily, but if you were of a mind to, you could do a lot worse than biting into one of my hand-bred and hand-washed 11 Urban Spices chicken legs.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's not out of the question. Now...
I imagine you'd have multiple takes. I know enough about Hollywood to know that they don't get it in one take.
No, that's correct.
So we would be happy to supply you with a whole bucket of chicken, and then you could just bite as many of them as you want. And if in the final film we see Henry VIII chowing down on an entire bucket of Kentucky Fried Chicken, well, that's so much the better, you see.
Well, of course, the bucket is a different conversation entirely, but, Colonel, may I be frank?
Of course, Mr. Burton.
Call me Richard.
All right, Richard.
The fact is, I'm very keen to profess my love for Elizabeth with a jewel that's the size of a walnut. It's extremely expensive.
Uh-huh.
And right now, the entire reason I'm doing this motion picture, which, between you and me, is a very poor script.
Oh, does it? That's bad, I suppose.
Yes. The only reason I'm doing it is to raise capital to buy this jewel. To see a sparkle in the eye of my beloved... And to know that I've done everything I can in my power to make her happy. Do you understand?
I reckon I do.
Good. And what sort of offer were you going to make?
I'm glad to see you're a man who likes to get down to brass tacks. I'm willing to offer you $250.
Oh, dear.
Now, I couldn't pay it to you all at once. We'd have to split that up into two or three payments. But if you ask around, I think you'll find that Harland Sanders, his word is as strong as oak.
Yes, well, I do appreciate the offer very much, Colonel. I can tell that that you are a man of great honor, but not a very deep pocket, I'm afraid.
Well, pockets are as deep as anybody else's, I guess.
Colonel, I'm afraid this discussion is drawing to a close.
Oh.
Thank you very much for the offer. Best of luck to
you. Wait, I might be able to get it up to 275. He's probably distracted, and I understand he does like to take a drink now and then. And maybe that's what I ought to do, get together with him down there at the commissary and have a beer or two and talk it over like men. I'm sure he'll see the sense of it.